to pull the trigger and have it hit a target hundreds to even thousands of meters away is a marvelous feat. But the fact that you are aiming at a long-distance target complicates things just a little bit more. And there are a few mathematical components to take into consideration to ensure that you don't miss the target high, low, to the left, or to the right. If you're interested in this video, please continue watching. But before that, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so the next time I upload a video, you'll be sure to get notified. So let's begin. It's not often that a seasoned marksman would listen to a YouTube video telling them how to shoot long range better. But believe me, it is science, and anybody can do it with the right knowledge and understanding. Skilled snipers are known for their marksmanship. Next to maintenance and safety, accurate marksmanship is of critical importance, especially when you're shooting long range. Some are naturally good marksmen, while others need years of practice and dedication. Long-range sniping requires fine-tuned cognitive and physical skills coupled with physics, art, and a bit of luck. Most important is the expert-like awareness of how a bullet traveling over 1,000 miles per hour will interact with its surrounding throughout its trajectory. And a few factors to consider are gravity, spindrift, the wind, air density, temperature, altitude, and even the Earth's rotation. Yes, believe it or not, that does play a factor. However, everyone has a different theory on how a sniper rifle shoots long distances. My take on it starts with understanding the obstacles that stand between the sniper and the target and how one should adjust to land the shot. Let's start with the first and most important factor, gravity. As soon as the bullet leaves the barrel, gravity is already an acting force pushing the bullet downwards. The longer the bullet is in the air, the faster and further it will fall, which is why long-range shooting is so challenging because it's difficult to take all factors into consideration at the same time. A bullet will fall at the rate of gravity, which is 9.8 meters per second. After the first second in the air, the bullet will then fall an additional 9.8 meters per second for every second it is still traveling through the air. This means that the longer the bullet travels through the air, the faster and further it will fall after each additional second in transit. For distances from 100 to 200 meters, a bullet will fall only 4 inches. However, for distances from 900 to 1,000 meters, the bullet will fall over 100 inches during travel. The good news about gravity is once you calculate the rate at which the bullet falls for each targeted distance, you can then calculate the same distance for all future targets because gravity does not change. It stays consistent at 9.8 meters per second. Lucky for you, modern sniper rifles have made it convenient for the shooter by automating this process with an elevation knob that allows you to adjust for how high or low the firearm will shoot. As you turn this knob for adjustment, it will have clicks, which are referred to as the minute of angle, MOA. Every click is about 1/4 inch of a turn and accounts for 100 yards in distance. So, whatever distance you are shooting, you can simply account for the number of clicks needing to be made in your minute of angle. Next up is a factor called spindrift. Spindrift occurs when a force is applied directly to a spinning bullet. The sheer force of gravity acting on the bullet will send it either to the left or to the right of the intended trajectory. The direction of the twist in the rifle barrel will correlate to the direction for where the bullet will travel. The effects of spindrift on the bullet can vary depending on the distance, but generally speaking, for every 1,000 meters of distance, the bullet can be impacted by 8 inches or more in either direction. Theoretically speaking, spindrift is easy to calculate. However, practically, things are not going to be exact. There is a specific formula used to properly calculate the spindrift of a bullet, but that is not in the scope of this video. Next, one of the biggest and most challenging factors to consider is the wind. When the bullet is fired, even the slightest change in air movement causes it to drift, which is why it's difficult to gauge the wind because it's the ultimate unknown factor. For example, a bullet can move at a distance of around 5 inches for every 1 mile per hour of wind. So be sure to take this into consideration when aligning your shot because winds as seemingly slow as 5 miles per hour could alter your target 25 inches in one direction or another. Another factor to consider when shooting long range is you could have a crosswind, meaning there could be a 2 mile per hour gust of wind where you set up your rifle, but the wind could be moving 4 or 5 miles per hour in the opposite direction where the target is. This is where the part of art and luck both come into play. Wherever shooting, look for natural indicators like the direction of leaves or tall grass blowing in the wind. In some instances, drift smoke or dust can also help to determine how fast the wind is moving. Or you can invest in a handheld anemometer for calculating the wind speed more accurately. Nevertheless, calculating the wind speed at long distance is extremely difficult. When taking the wind into consideration, practice and experience are the major factors. Practice makes perfect, but nothing compares to an experienced marksman. But let's not forget about a few other important factors, which are air density, air temperature, and altitude. Anybody with little to no experience watching this video might be wondering how on earth the air density, air temperature, and altitude matter in long-distance shooting. Well, it all boils down to science. Let's start with air density. There are three main factors that can influence the density of the air. These three are the air pressure, air temperature, and the humidity level. More air pressure will equate to denser air, which will in turn slow the bullet speed down and create a lower impact on the target. The air temperature will actually have an opposite effect on the air's density. The higher the air temperature, the lower the density the air will be. This can have an effect when you're shooting at higher altitudes, but essentially it will have a canceling effect because the higher the altitude, the lower the air pressure, but the higher the altitude, the lower the air temperature. Air temperature is actually another factor that is highly overlooked when shooting because the environment marksmen practice in can be totally different than the environment they will be shooting in, especially if you're training in the middle of the summer with higher air temperatures and then are shooting again in the same exact location, but now it's winter time and the temperature significantly dropped. The final, yet most important factor that plays a vital role when shooting a sniper rifle long distance is the Earth's rotation. This is known as the Coriolis effect. If you know someone who has ever shot a rifle at this distance, they will tell you that the bullet will travel for almost 10 seconds if shot at a distance of over 3,000 meters before hitting the target. But why is this? Earth's rotation plays a role. When shooting north or south in the northern hemisphere, the bullet will likely hit right of the target. If shooting north or south in the southern hemisphere, the bullet will end up to the left of the target. If shooting from the east, the bullet will probably land higher than you aimed for. And if shooting from the west, yep, you guessed it, the bullet will land lower than what you aimed for. Although, the Coriolis effect is not as prominent in the east or west direction as it is in the north or south direction. The longer the distance you are shooting, the more the Coriolis effect is compounded, but it has the most effect in the north and south poles and the least effect closest to the equator. Now that you know the seven factors in science behind shooting a sniper rifle long distance, there are some techniques that you need to grasp for perfection. There are five firing fundamentals of rifle firing: aim, breath control, movement control, trigger control, and follow through. Let's discuss each element in detail. Aligning your aim. 1. Align your sight with the target. 2. To reduce eye strain and ease focus, keep both eyes open. 3. Ensure that your aiming time is brief. Controlling your breathing. 1. Your breathing technique while aiming can affect your shot. So, take some deep breaths and when releasing the last breath, exhale about half of it. 2. As you squeeze the trigger, hold your breath. 3. Don't hold your breath for too long as it can make the rifle move. 4. Make sure you're relaxed. If you feel nervous, take a few more deep breaths before pulling the trigger. Holding your aim. 1. Focus on how the target is moving. 2. try to minimize any and all body movement. Pulling the trigger. 1. Grasp the stock firmly. 2. Position your finger comfortably on the trigger. 3. Apply slow pressure until the rifle fires. Follow through. 1. Continue to squeeze the trigger to prevent any sort of jerking, as this can be the difference between you missing or hitting your target. I researched the internet, went through blogs and forums, and talked to experts regarding what they do to perfect long-range shooting. To my surprise, the tips I received were unique and thought they were worth sharing. 1. Collect data. The first one is collecting data. The majority of seasoned shooters emphasize this aspect, but why? Data is important. If you keep a record of every bullet you fired, you will know what your sniper rifle will do under every condition. Many marksmen use this data as a reference before every long-distance shot. This significantly increases their odds of hitting the target. 2. Shoot dirty. The most bizarre tip ever received when it comes to long-range sniper shooting is to shoot dirty guns. It may be surprising, but many marksmen prefer not cleaning the rifles for the entire season. This probably goes against everything your dad has taught you growing up at deer camp. 3. Squeeze on the paws. Some shooters claim that they like to shoot on the respiratory paws on the down breath. For example, if you are taking 3 deep breaths in and out after your exhale from the last breath, pause. This is when you want to take the shot. 4. Study the wind. This is one of the most important tips of them all. Wind can make or break a perfect shot. Because you will be hundreds or even possibly thousands of meters away, there will be multiple wind directions. In this situation, it is really difficult to gauge the wind. The wind can also affect the bullet speed between you and the target, so always keep the wind in check. 5. Adjust the angle correctly. Sometimes the shot is so difficult that you may have to go to the extreme. Whether you are on a plain grassland or a hilly terrain, hitting the target can be tricky, as you will be posed with a high or low angle shooting dilemma. In that case, it would be advised that you shoot with a partner who can also double as your spotter. Perfecting long range targets is all about practice and a little understanding of physics with a pinch of luck. Having self-confidence is a key, and experience is everything. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. And for more interesting videos like this, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, turn on notifications, and most importantly, share. Until then, we'll see you in the next video.